Good afternoon mga kababayan. Ito pong ulo ng ating mga balita sa araw na ito. It is Wednesday, 24th of April, 2024. Dito sa South China Sea ay mukhang nagkakainitan. There has been an upsurge in Chinese militia vessels habang merong baliktad drills with the US and the Philippines. Yun po yung sa South China Sea. In the meantime, the US Senate passed the $95 billion foreign exchange foreign aid package for the three countries that are currently at war. New York Times, ito po yung aid for Ukraine, Israel and Taiwan. And ang Washington Post sinabi, kinonfirm din that ipinasa na ang aid para sa Ukraine, Israel and Taiwan after months of debate. So ano ngayon ang kinalaman nito sa ating broadcast ngayon? Because of this war, because of the ongoing war in Ukraine, in Israel, in Gaza, in the Middle East, and in South China Sea, apektado po yung ating mga overseas Filipino workers, yung ating mga skilled workers na dapat ay nadideploy, let's say, sa Middle East or in these countries where they're affected by the war, mukhang mahihirapan sila. So, bibigyan po natin ng option ang ating mga skilled workers. Which country would be the best when you want to migrate or work? Kung nagkakagulo sa Middle East, nagkakagulo sa South China Sea, hindi makalakad ang mga barko, ang ating mga seaman, ang ating mga land-based workers, hindi makalakad. So, ang ating topic ngayon would be, which country offers the best visa options for skilled workers? You can apply for your permanent residency even when you're here in the Philippines. So, yun po yung ating tatalakayin. And, sino yung ating umuna? Si Abella. Okay. Hindi ko mabasa pero sige, balikan po natin yan. Okay. Ito yung ating topic. Alright. Which country offers the best visa option? Okay. Which country offers the best visa option for skilled workers? Okay. Balikan natin. And just to give you an idea, ang US and UK, hindi po sila points-based. They don't accept workers. They don't accept permanent migration application. Because they're not points-based. Ang UK hindi points-based, ang US hindi rin points-based. Ang US, meron silang family sponsorship or employment-based category if you want to migrate to those countries. And sa UK, you must have worked for at least 5 years legally to qualify for indefinite leave to remain. So, kung hindi kayo pwede yan sa mga bansa na yan, sa UK and sa US, eto yung bansa na number one, alphabetical, Australia. Paano kayong pwede mag-apply sa Australia if you're an overseas worker, if you're a skilled worker, andito kayo sa Pilipinas, naghihintay kayo na magkaroon ng peace in the Middle East, baka matatagalan pa, or you cannot leave kasi yung barko ninyo hindi makaalis because sa South China Sea. Pwede nyo pag-isipan. Australia is one of the countries that offers one of the best visa option. And pwede kayo mag-apply even now as a skilled independent. Yung skilled independent ay subclass 189. It is points based or points tested. Yung subclass 189, you are applying from here without any employer. Okay? Your occupation must be on the occupations list, and your occupation must be assessed by the assessing authority in Australia para kayo magkaroon ng points. So ano ngayon? Umpisa tayo sa average age ng mga overseas worker natin is 34. So if you are 33 and less than 40, you get 25 points. Remember, age between 33 and 40, you get 25 points. Sa education, if you have a bachelor's degree or the equivalent in trade qualification, bachelor's degree is 15 points. Kung meron kayong PhD, then it will be 20 points. Kung ito ay diploma lamang or trade qualification, it will be 10 points. And yung experience ninyo, if you have less than 5 years, at least 5, less than 8 years, then you can get 10 points. Kung ito ay 8 or 10 years, then you get 20 points. You need English proficiency. Ito yan, English proficiency. Is either proficient or superior. Proficient, kung ang inyong IELTS ay 7 in all scores, speaking, reading, writing, and listening, you get 7, then you get 10 points. If you get more than, if you get 8 in speaking, reading, and writing, then you get 20 points. When your skill is assessed, remember, your skill must be assessed, your occupation must be on the list, your occupation must be assessed by the assessing authority, you must pay for the assessment fee, and once that is done, you get 10 points. Ayan, 10 points. Okay? So, kung hindi kayo nag-aral sa Australia, and hindi kayo wala kayong relatives sa Australia, but if you're single, you get 10 points. So, tingnan natin ang potential scores ninyo. If you are between 23, 33, and 40, then you get 25 points. 33, less than 40, you get 25 points. Meron kang bachelor's degree, you get 15 points. You have at least 5 years, but less than 8 years, then you get 10 points. Ang English mo is more proficient, so IELTS mo is 7 in all factors, then you get 10 points. Na-assess yung skills mo, let's say, as a seaman or as a computer programmer, as a teacher or an accountant, then you get 10 points. And if you're single, you get 10 points. So, ang total mo is 80 points. Anong kinalaman ngayon ng 80 points? Ang minimum is 65. So, anong kinalaman ng 80 points? Yan, in the last invitation ng Australia sa Skill Select na ni-issue nila, that was December pa, last year. So, matagal na. So, mapapansin nyo, yung Skilled Independent, subclass 189, they had invited 8,300 applicants na mag-apply ng kanilang residency. Nag-apply sila through express of interest. Yung isa naman, meron sila mga families sa Australia, so 79 ang nabigyan ng invitation. So marami talaga yung skilled independent even without family in Australia or even if hindi ka nag-aral sa Australia, ito yan, skilled independent. The minimum score, the minimum qualifying score for most professions is 65. So yung highest is 80. So balikan natin ngayon itong scoring. So kung if you are between 33 and less than 40, you get 25 points. Meron kang bachelor's degree, you get 15 points. You have at least 5 years experience, less than 8, you get 10 points. You have your English proficiency, you have been assessed. So all in all, you can get 80 points. So makakasama ka dun sa may imbitahan. Okay? Especially if your occupation is in demand. Remember, meron silang occupations list. So balikan natin siya. Ayan. And eto ngayon yan. Ngayon lang po ito. Sinasabi ng Australia, there's a massive shortfall. Marami silang kailangang workers. So pagkakataon nyo na. Ngayon, anong sabi ng Australian government? Ito yung mga for skilled workers intending to stay up to 4 years sa Australia. Meron kayong employer, you will be staying for at least 1 to 4 years. Ito yung subclass 482, ito yung temporary skill shortage visa. Subclass 489, skilled regional provisional visa. You will be nominated by state or territorial government. You need 65 points to qualify. So if you get 80 points, qualified ka na. Subclass 489. Then yung subclass 491, kailangan ng nasa occupations list. And ito ay para sa mga state and territory nominated na you will be working in regional Australia. Yung last one is subclass 491, you can be eligible for permanent residency after working for 3 years. Ito yung subclass 491. In all of these subclasses, you need an employer. So, paano kayo makakahanap ng employer? Ito ngayon yan. You can go to the website of the Department of Migrant Workers. You look for the approved job orders. And hanapin ninyo yung sa Australia. Kung mayroong mga available na job sa Australia, then you can check. You can check the agency, the licensed agency offering the job. Ang Immigrant Visa Center po is not a recruitment agency, but an advocacy firm. We're just providing information para sa ating mga kababayan so that you can get updated information on what your future might be, your career and future. So once you have an employer in any of these subclasses, then you can check it out with the Department of Migrant Workers doon sa approved job orders nila. And kasi mga approved job orders sa DMW, ito ay verified ng mga labor attaché natin doon sa Australia. And once you have the verified offer, job offer, you can submit your application sa BFS Global for Australia. Alright? Yun po yung ating overview para sa ating mga kababayan who may be looking at Australia as the potential na kanilang pwedeng they can work and migrate habang naghihintay na magkaroon ng peace sa Middle East at magkaroon ng kalutasan ang South China Sea. Medyo matatagal lang po yan. Kaya medyo tingnan natin, you should explore other visa options while just waiting. Hindi naman pwede naghihintay lang kayo. Diba? Okay. So, if you need a free assessment, ito po yung ating offer sa IBC Immigrant Visa Center. We can give you a free assessment for global mobility sa Australia. Just email us or email your complete updated bio data to visacenter@gmail.com, or you can also give us a call. Text or call 0917-526-8472 or 0917-531-8472. But for a free assessment, it would be good if you can send us your email, if you can email us your resume sa visacenter@gmail.com. Ang atin pong susunod na tatalakayin ay New Zealand. But before that, magpapaalam po muna tayo para mahaba na po masyado ito, para hindi kayo masyadong mawala ng battery ang inyong phone kung kayo nanonood sa inyong cellphone. Ito po inyong KaVisa Cris for our topic this week. Australia po ang ating inuna. Anong country ang may magandang offer for skilled workers? Ito po inyong KaVisa Cris. Until next time, hasta la visa, mga KaVisa.